Good evening and welcome to MTV News Update for today, Thursday, February 15, 2018. In the news tonight, President Granger taking COI one step at a time. Jagdeo warns against appointing top judicial officers without due consultation and approval. Many sugar workers will not receive benefits from NIS. And in court, South Rheinwald duo remanded for a spate of armed robberies. With the details of these and other stories, I'm Sandy Ramudar, thanking you for joining us. Now for the news and details. President David Granger says he's taken one commission of inquiry at a time, even though the opposition is calling for a combined inquiry to look into the crime wave period. Nikhil Jaunu begins tonight's newscast.
President David Granger, while addressing senior police officers this morning, said that several other commissions of inquiry will be established to look into the troubled times. President Granger listed a number of incidents which took place under the previous administration's tenure.
Massacres which are to be investigated in due course. According to Kitty in September 2002, in Lamahal Gardens in October 2002, in Border in November 2002, Buxton Friendship in June 2003, Prashad Nagar in June 2003, Agricola Eccles in February 2006, La Bonne Intention, or as my Francophone friends would say, La Bonne Intention, in April 2006, in Bagotstown Eccles in August 2006, at Blackbush Pold in August 2006, in Lusignan in June 2008, in Bartica in February 2008, and as you now learn from the media, in Lindo Creek in June 2008. It is incomprehensible.
He posited that the COIs will bring to the fore the extent to which the previous administration was involved in the illegal activities. The president said that period was the worst since post-independence.
The daily newspapers inform us how a covert counterforce had to be brought into existence to perform law enforcement functions, functions which belong under the Constitution only to the legitimate police force. Numerous questions arise from these careless remarks. Who comprised, who commanded, who controlled that counterforce? Officers, our country endured two decades of woulda, coulda, and shoulda.
He added that after the assassination of former Agriculture Minister Satidi Yassar, there was never a coroner's inquest. President Granger said a magistrate in any of the magisterial districts can initiate an inquest of any unnatural deaths.
There's no discretion to the magistrate or the magistracy to have an inquest. Once it's an unnatural death, there should have been an inquest. So there's no schedule, there's no program. Of course, we have limitations. We could only make one step at a time. But we need to arrive at the truth in order to prevent any recurrence of those atrocities.
When questioned on the remarks made by a past head of state and prime minister, President Granger said he would not reply to their public pronouncement. The two past government officials had stated that persons should be granted immunity for any misdemeanor which would have taken place during the troubled times.
The former Prime Minister has not written me. I'm not aware of such a request. There's a leader of the opposition, and if he wants to make such a proposal, he could do so. But there's no request before me. I don't respond to the former President's Ramatar. I don't normally respond to that.
Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
The opposition party is warning the government not to go ahead with the appointment of top judicial officers until after consulting with the leader of the opposition, Bharat Jagdeo. Jagdeo warns if that is done, trouble looms for Guyana. Here's more. Opposition leader Bar Jagdeo says trouble looms if the president is green-lighted by the attorney general to appoint persons in top judicial posts.
Well, if this president is awaiting advice from this AG, our AG, we're in for big trouble, because this attorney general has proven over and over again his inability to deal with complex issues. But this is a straightforward one. So not complex, actually I should say simple issues. His inability to deal even with simple issues.
He also reiterated his position on the nominees, which was outlined in a letter sent to the Ministry of the Presidency. Moreover, he lashed back at the president for bashing him after he did not attend a meeting to discuss the appointments of the Chancellor of the Judiciary and the Chief Justice.
Dishonesty for all these years, using this now as an excuse for maybe more unconstitutional acts in the future. Because if he moves to appoint a substantive Chancellor and Chief Justice, he'll not only go in the face of the Constitution, he would not only be violating the Constitution, but the excuse that he's using to do that will be spurious.
Kenneth Benjamin was nominated for the position of Chancellor of the Judiciary and Justice Yonet Cummings Edwards as Chief Justice. Article 127(1) of the Constitution states that the Chancellor and Chief Justice shall be appointed by the President, acting after consultation with the minority leader. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update. Adding to the woes of the retrenched sugar workers, especially those who are aged, is the fact that some of them will not be receiving benefits from the National Insurance Scheme. According to the Ghana Agricultural and General Workers Union, they did not make enough contributions to benefit. Here is more. President of the Ghana Agricultural and General Workers Union, GAU, Komal Chan, says a number of retrenched workers are frustrated as they would not be receiving their old age benefits. He was at the time referring to contributions paid to the National Insurance Scheme. Old age benefit from NIS is payable to insured persons who have attained the age of 60 years. To qualify for the pensionable plan, one must pay at least 750 contributions, which is equivalent to 15 years of continuous work. According to him, many of the workers are short on their contributions and they're unsure they will be employed soon to continue making their contributions. Also, others are just mere years away from their retirement age of 55 years.
Yeah, but the NIS contribution, they have within 1 year to work and make voluntary contribution. If 1 year passed since they last contributed to when they want to start, we are encouraging them to do that. And in our next union paper, we're going to inform them about this. We will refer to the law, quote what the NIS law says, and encourage them to do that. Who can understand the importance if they could keep paying, though it will be a small sum they will pay, and the pension, because what the NIS does, they take the last 5 years of your earnings and they take the best 3 years and they calculate your NIS pension. But if they make voluntary contribution, it will be a small contribution. But it will be better to get an NIS pension when you reach age 60 than don't get anything.
Coupled with this, the retrenched workers will not be able to benefit from sickness benefits as they are now redundant. In addition to this, they will not be able to benefit from the Sugar Welfare Fund, which usually grants loans only to active sugar workers. Adding to the frustration, the limited funds obtained from severance will last just about a couple months, says Chan.
But they would be spending from it. And though they would not spend as much as when they were working, it wouldn't last, you know, for some years. It will last for some months. It depends how they spend and so on. It depends if sickness visited the family and this kind of situation developed. So one has to understand is a limited sum when you get your severance from a job to to give you that opportunity to go about and secure another job. Generally, when your work becomes redundant, and redundancy is expected to be small scale, so there are small number of people could try to find job anywhere, and that severance that unions fought for and workers fought for over the years in the period of the Industrial Revolution and onward is to tidy over for a short period, not for all the time.
Moreover, the union has been supporting the workers through court cases, community meetings and visits, as well as marches. On a positive note, there are speculations that investors have cited an interest in keeping sugar at the estates. Some 75 investors have expressed their interest for divestment of the sugar estates, according to the Special Purpose Unit. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update. More news still ahead. Do stay tuned.
Ready for the season's biggest fan. Stock Stage 6. Two nights, one stage. On February 21st, performing live, Heatwave Band, Quasis, Nadia Matson, Destra and our band, Orphan Alex, and Kerry John. And February 22nd, Heatwave Band, Jomo, Ultimate Rejects, and the Farmanapi. Stock Stage 6 at the National Park Tarmac. Tickets are not on sale. Buy two Stock specials and get a season pass. Specials may vary at different outlets. Stock Stage 6, powered by Stagline. And stack a man's beer.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
What good is history if you never change? And what good is change if it doesn't make you better? At Valvoline, for the last 150 years, we've been doing just that. Relentlessly pursuing innovation for your engine. Backed up not just by science, but by the hands-on expertise that drives everything we do. Valvoline, 150 years under the hood.
You're still with News Update, welcome back. The alleged mastermind behind a carjacking ring is being sought by investigators as another stolen vehicle was seized during another operation. Nicole Jondu with the details.
Divisional Commander Marlon Chapman says 14 persons have been arrested and are in police custody assisting with the investigations. Since last Friday, the police have made several discoveries of stolen vehicles and accessories. Those discoveries were made at Yarkabra and Kurukururu on the Linden-Suzak Highway, Lodge and Vrysla's East Coast Demerara. Commander Chapman says investigators are pursuing the alleged mastermind behind the illegal trade.
The cooperation has been excellent from members of the public, particularly in that Kurukururu Yarkabra area. And so the information is forthcoming, we're acting upon it, and much to say about the success. I cannot help but commending the members of the public for giving us the information and the assistance, and the ranks who are on the investigation. Kudos to my entire team, A Division, A as in A plus.
Commissioner of Police Silal Prasad says the force is working in collaboration with the Ghana Revenue Authority to trace the documentation of the stolen vehicles and accessories.
GRA has always been cooperative. The issue we have with cooperation with a lot of companies is if the information we ask for is readily available, or they have to deploy and search. You know, it's how you store information. that determines the length of time, and then if you have to deploy additional resources, what priority it falls, and so on. So.
Meantime, the police swooped down at a Lodge Housing Scheme residence and arrested a 52-year-old woman. The police, in a statement, said Rangs found a black Mazda Axela motor car with license number PTT2794. In addition, 12 certificates of registration for various vehicles, including those that were seized from the home of an ex-policeman. Police said the woman's name is on two of the seized vehicles' registration. Investigations are ongoing. Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
The first public hearing of the Lindo Creek Commission of Inquiry has been postponed. Retired Justice Don Trotman says due to unanticipated circumstances, the commission would not consult any hearings until certain internal issues are remedied. Here's Yanis Abrams.
We had scheduled the commencement of public hearings from today, but due to regrettable circumstances over which we have no control, the commission has no control whatsoever, because certain important prerequisite arrangements for the functioning of the commission have not been put in place, we are unable to hold any public hearings, and for that matter, any other inquiries, until these important prerequisites have been put in place.
That was the Commissioner of the Lindo Creek COI, retired Justice Donald Trotman, making the announcement after meter operatives waited approximately an hour for the inquiry to begin. The chairman stated the witnesses scheduled to testify today were the relatives of the deceased.
I think it's a matter of logistics, transportation. Many of them live pretty far out. And while we have been in telephonic communication with them, we have not had, in many cases, direct communication with them in out of Georgetown locations.
Retired Justice Trotman said he hopes by Monday, February 19, which is the next expected hearing date, the matters are resolved and the sessions can commence.
We are hoping, because we have scheduled some hearings for next week. I think the media has already been notified about those, Madam Secretary. And we are hoping to, today is Thursday, we had not scheduled anything for tomorrow, but we hope that we can continue in the next week as scheduled and as you have been informed.
The Commission of Inquiry into the circumstances that led to the deaths of the 8 men at Lindo Creek Upper Demerara River is another inquest established by the Granger government. The government is seeking to bring closure to the many murders which occurred during the early 2000s, a period the president calls the Troubles. Meanwhile, the COI is being mocked by the opposition leader Bara Jagdeo, who alleges that it is politically motivated. He has since backed his claim by the fact that the commissioner is the father of Natural Resources Minister Raphael Trotman. Reporting for MTV's News Update, I am Yanis Abrams.
Opposition leader Bara Jagdeo, who is disheartened by the petroleum contract, has promised that the opposition will participate if the government decides to renegotiate the agreement. Find out more in this report. Opposition leader Bara Jagdeo predicts that the country will be tremendously harmed due to the alleged incompetence of the government. He was at the time referring to speculations that there might be a renegotiation of the petroleum agreement. The petroleum agreement is said to be in the hands of cabinet. Following perusal of the contract, Jagdeo is requesting to know what steps will be taken if blunders are found. In such a case, the government should acknowledge their error, he explained.
So what if the review finds that, like most people have found, that the contract is horrible, a horrible one, an incompetently negotiated one? then what should be your position as a country? So no government in the world works this way, with such levels of incompetence.
He has also cited his party's interest in meeting the government at the negotiating table to share its views on the contract. The opposition party has pinpointed a number of clauses in the contract, which has drawn major concern.
Okay, so what I would hope is if that's the cabinet has statutory powers, the president, etc. If they manage the executive at this time, assuming they review this contract and they have an approach on it, I would think that they first, and they want to approach it in a bipartisan manner, we will be willing to meet with them.
Meanwhile, only yesterday, President Granger informed that though the contract is being considered by cabinet, there is no immediate plan to have it reviewed. Guyana signed the revised petroleum agreement with Esso Exploration and Production Guyana Limited, Nexim Petroleum Guyana Limited, and Hess Guyana Exploration Limited in June of 2016. The contract is a production sharing agreement which gives the contractor permission to explore and produce petroleum in a demarcated area. Sandy Ramotar for MTV's News Update. Coming up, President Granger charges officers to win the public's trust, and deplorable roads in Grove frustrate residents.
Stage on February 21st, performing live, Heatwave Band, Quasis, Nadia Matson, Destra and our band, Orphan Alex, and Kerry John. And February 22nd, Heatwave Band, Jomo, Ultimate Rejects, and the Farmer Nappy. Stack Stage 6 at the National Park Tarmac. Tickets are not on sale. Buy two Stack Specials and get a season pass. Specials may vary at different outlets. Stack Stage 6, powered by Staglight and Stack, a man's beer.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
BB, is where you going with so much Windex for clean windows? All them fancy curtains, it's not even Christmas.
Hi, girl, mind your own business. I got big plans.
But BB, your house don't even have windows.
Girl, you ain't think I know it ain't got window? Yes, I know it ain't got window. But look, Mokesh promised me that he carrying me down by the window factory when he come home at Eccles. It named Beeson. Like you ain't know nothing, girl. Right now, everybody talking about how Beeson got the strongest windows. Plus, they got a deal right now. If you buy 10 windows, you get a free bathroom window. So I could mind your business instead of you minding my own.
Beeson Windows and Doors, serving Guyana with the highest quality standard windows for your home, office, or commercial building.
This is MTV News Update. Thank you for staying tuned. President David Granger has charged officers to win the public's confidence. This was the thrust of his message when he spoke at the annual Police Officers Conference. Nika Jondu has more.
The annual conference is being held under the theme, Forging Ahead with Effective Policing through Strategic Human Resources and Operational Management, Partnership and Professionalism. President David Granger, in addressing the police officers, said the security sector reform is being implemented by the British government. He noted that the reform is being done in such a way that would protect citizens. The head of state also noted that the government will resist those who have sinister plans to derail the implementation of the reform.
Security reform is not a recent invention of this administration. The need became evident, especially during a period of intense criminal violence known as the Troubles. The reform project, regrettably, became a victim of political prevarication.
President Granger believes that the time has come for corrupt officers to leave the force. He noted that if an officer has committed an illegal act, then that person should not be transferred or demoted to a lower position.
The best efforts of the Office of Professional Responsibility and of the Police Complaints Authority could be undermined by corrupt senior officers who condone the misconduct of subordinates. They do the force no good, but rather damage the careers, and worse yet, endanger the lives of honest policemen and jeopardize public security.
The three-day conference seeks to review the force's operations last year, the technologies used to arrest crime, and unprofessional behavior of police ranks.
So it is anticipated that there will be intense discussions regarding the development of support systems for commanders in order to achieve the control, that control function of management. Controlling the rates of unprofessional behavior, reducing response time, reducing investigation and prosecution backlog will be major objectives.
Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
The relatives of the deceased Marlon Fredericks are calling for a murder charge to be instituted on the city police who is responsible for his death. According to the persons who held another protest, it is a planned murder. Mourners Lishana Gomes currently this report.
Earlier today, several persons, including the aunt of Marlon Fredericks, protested in the vicinity of City Hall, calling for justice for her deceased nephew. 34-year-old Marlon Fredericks was killed at the hands of a city constable on January 14 whilst trying to escape from confinement at the Border City Constabulary. He was arrested for simple larceny. His aunt, Natasha Mohammed, boldly rejected the slow situation of justice from the state regarding the untimely death of her nephew. She is calling for justice to be given where it is deserved.
I mean, he didn't deserve. What he got, he didn't deserve that. I mean, every Guyanese, I would say, right? They deserve the right to live, right? So what has been done to him, I think it's totally injustice. So we would like justice. We don't need no compensation. We don't need no compensation, right? We need the legal justice to prevail.
Meanwhile, social activist Dawn Singh strongly related that the current charge of manslaughter placed before the city constable is not fitting. He is calling for a murder charge to be instituted.
A case of premeditation can be proven, and that will take time, I suppose. But the charge has to be murder. It can't be manslaughter. Do the right things. Now, whilst the mayor has said that, look, the police will handle matters, where did the police get their statements from? It comes from the city constabulary. And they will go from there on those. So what I am saying is, first of all, the city constabulary has to stop. They need retraining. We need to know who's training them, why market police are carrying firearms amongst crowded streets of Georgetown. There's a whole system that needs to stop. Minister Volkan needs to step in and stop this nonsense.
On Thursday, January 18, Lance Corporal Gregory Bascom was officially charged with manslaughter and subsequently placed on $800,000 bail after he appeared before a city magistrate for the unlawful killing of Marlon Fredericks. Since being placed on bail, many public-spirited persons, including the family of Fredericks, believes the system of justice is being blurred. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lishana Gomes, Cornelius.
Residents of an East Bank Demerara community are peeved with the Neighborhood Democratic Council as some roads there are in a deplorable state. The residents are frustrated as they continue to pay their rates and taxes. Here again is Lashana Gomes Cornelius.
The deplorable state of the road leading into Back Street has been a major concern for residents, young and old. According to Sumintra Rupnarine, the community's residents have been paying their required rates and taxes and are baffled as to why no active steps have been taken to address the issue.
This is the main road for the school children them use, and look the condition. We are not pigs, we are human beings. And we are paying rate and tax. And what service we get? You pay maintenance for vehicle use the road, road taxes and service, and can vehicle come in here. If you have a sick, you call a taxi, they tell you plane, they ain't coming in. $300 is fair, you have to pay $1,000 if they come in. Can it be fair?
Other disheartened residents vehemently dispelled their concerns over the long-standing situation. Many of them blame the present state of the roads and incapable drainage system on what they term as the inadequate functioning of the Neighborhood Democratic Council.
Nothing in doing here. I don't know what's going on. When you call it, the chairman there, I got something to tell you. And the squatting area, and Caneville, which is the next squatting area, got good road, tar road. Look what we got to go through here. I got a business there, nobody not coming and buy because the road bad, you know. It's terrible how we live here, man. Kids got to use this street here to go to school. It's impossible, you know. We need something to do about it. You pay your rates and tax and we're not getting no results from it. Plus, they got the pigs them walking up and down here. Up and down the pigs them walking. When you call the council, you don't even see them. You don't even know who is the councillor, who is the chairman, who is the sanitary. Nobody now come around and say nothing. When you go there and tell them, oh, they're going to look into it. You never see them back again.
It is wasting time. When you go to make a complaint, they tell you have to bring out a group of people. Where you going to go when you carry rates and tax? You don't care a group of people. You go alone and pay your rates and tax. I don't call for the neighbors to go and pay rates and tax. So why when you go make a complaint, they tell you have to go with a set of people? You got to write a letter. We don't write a letter to go and pay rates and tax. They just collect your rates and tax. What's happening here? What is happening here?
Meanwhile, when contact was made with the local NDC in the area, News Update was reliably informed that preliminary works were done in June of last year. The works included the leveling of loam on the road. The clearing of debris from drains is done every 3 months. Though rates and taxes are regularly paid, the NDC blames much of the situation on insufficient subvention to deal with such works. The NDC is currently taking steps to gain the support of the Ministry of Public Infrastructure to come on board and assist with the situation. As regards the state of the alleyway drains, the local authority revealed that it is the residents who continue to dump their waste there, causing a buildup of debris. The NDC urges all residents to desist from such actions. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes Cornelius.
Still ahead, Japan grants Guyana US $270,000 for development projects.
Let me tell you. Our secret! So they can't tell you. A secret of a secret. Miko, palam!
The heavy catch you!
The secret is out! Tyo's Future Shop is the absolute best place to shop if you're looking for quality products at the lowest prices in the widest possible variety. Choose from a vast array of custom-made quality wooden furniture in endless designs, electrical and household appliances, clothing, cell phones and accessories, and much, much more.
Oh my God, so much in this store, guys! Me confused! And a price low, though?
Tayo's Future Shop and Household Appliances. Located at Anna Katerina, West Coast, Demerara. Free delivery available.
Credit!
Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Get ready for the season's biggest fair, Stack Stage 6. Two nights, one stage. On February 21st, performing live, Heatwave Band, Quasis, Nadia Batson, Destra and her band, Orphan Alex, and Kerry John. On February 22nd, Heatwave Band, Jomo, Ultimate Rejects, and Farmer Nappy. Stack Stage 6 at the National Park Diamond. Tickets are not on sale. Buy two Stack specials and get a season pass. Specials may vary at different outlets. Stack Stage 6, powered by Stack Light and Stack, a man's beer.
As the Ministry of Social Protection continues to improve the transparency, accountability, and service delivery of the senior citizens' pension system, we're kindly advising all beneficiaries of the senior citizens' pension to contact their nearest GCOM office and make an application to update their information to the 9-digit national identification card. As of March 1, 2018, the Ministry of Social Protection will not be facilitating the processing of senior citizens' pension vouchers without the presentation of the 9-digit identification card. We thank you for your cooperation.
This is a message from the Ministry of Social Protection.
You're tuned to News Update. Welcome back. The government of Guyana, in collaboration with the Japanese government, has signed on to 3 grassroots community development projects, which are some to be beneficial to persons living within those communities. Lashana Gomes-Cornelius has that story.
The Japanese government, in demonstrating its long-standing support to Guyana, donated a grant of over $270,000 towards the benefit of several community development grassroots projects integral to societal and human development within the country. Minister of Indigenous Peoples Affairs and Vice President Sidney Alicock, during his brief delivery, related that the grant being made by the Japanese government is one which is greatly appreciated and welcomed. According to one of the grant recipients, President of St. Francis Community Developments, located in Burbese, Alex Foster, briefly related on how the grant will play an important role in ensuring community development is widely attained.
Because Guyana was once considered the breadbasket of the Caribbean, I believe that we can reclaim that title by moving into non-traditional areas. And the Japanese government also have recognized that, and the government of Guyana. And we do hope that with your continuous support, that we will continuously deliver a service second to none.
Deputy Head of Mission, Embassy of Japan, Yoshinori Yakaba, announced that a grant will ensure that both educational and social services are afforded to the people of Guyana.
Through the signing of grant contract today, these 3 organizations will be better equipped to address the human security needs that exist within their respective communities and fulfill the very purpose for which the GGP scheme was created. Japan is pleased to support these organizations in their efforts, and we hope they will continue their work of providing essential educational and social services to the people of Guyana.
Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashana Gomes-Cornelius.
The Mayor and City Council will carry out another week of consultations to arrive at a garbage collection fee within Georgetown. This means that the council is still not obtaining revenue from collecting garbage from residents of the city. Find out more in this report.
The Mayor and City Council announced that, as of February 26, a one-week consultation will begin on the garbage collection fee for residents within Georgetown. Public Relations Officer Deborah Lewis stated, due to the lack of persons turning out as scheduled consultations, another set of consultations will commence.
You would have known that we would have had a series of public consultations with residents of various communities seeking to address the payment of proposed payment for the collection on disposal of garbage.
Director of Solid Waste Water Narine states that during the meetings, about 80% of the persons would agree, whilst the other said they already contribute to rates and taxes.
That figure could not represent truly Georgetown, because we know Georgetown has a population of over 200,000. So we want to roll out in the coming weeks another round of consultations, and we'll try to do it differently than we did. So we're hopeful that we can reach each household. But only a few of the residents had concerns, not paying, but the majority would have accepted, and we haven't defined a price range yet, or a price per se, but it was favorable towards paying the garbage.
It was shockingly revealed that 35 persons were the highest turnout at the three-week session. In a previous press conference, Tom Clark Royston King announced that the council will be introducing a fee of $200 per barrel for garbage collection from February 1 for homeowners in the city. Meanwhile, a few persons staged a picketing exercise outside of City Hall today, calling for the council to scrap the idea of garbage collection fee.
We are paying our rates and taxes throughout the year. I pay well over $250,000 a year in taxes. And then you come in and tell me that I got to pay between $5,000 and $12,000 a month.
Reporting for MTV's News Update, I am Yanis Abrams.
The University of Guyana Student Society intends to host an initiative called Soft Guyana. President of the student body, Noel Hines, says it is intended to be a platform for students to showcase student academic output. Here is Yanis Abrams.
The president of the University of Guyana Student Society, UGSS Noel Hines, is praising the student body for the amount of work done in 3 months after being elected. Hines mentioned talks are ongoing with the Athletics Association of Guyana to host the first InterVarsity Sports Day with other universities in Guyana. He further noted an initiative called Soft Guyana is expected to occur later this year.
Soft Guyana is intended to be a platform to showcase student academic output or students' efforts at innovation in the country. So it's where we gather real-life problems and have students apply their knowledge, their learning, their expertise to solving those problems and present that to the public, particularly the business community.
Hines related to News Update, they have been pushing for betterments for the Faculty of Agriculture since the students there feel neglected.
So far, the UGSS has focused a lot on bringing relief to students in the Faculty of Agriculture and Forestry. There, we worked with the Food for the Poor organization to hand over a very significant quantity of implements, agricultural implements for that faculty, which was part of the needs that had been raised during the UGSS elections. That is also, those equipment is also available for students at the Burbese campus, where there's an agricultural program also, a program in the Agri and Forestry faculty.
On October 31, 2017, a new president and executive body were administered their oaths of office by the University of Guyana Vice Chancellor, Professor Ivlaw Griffith. Reporting for MTV's News Update, I am Yanis Abrams.
Stay tuned for Court Roundup as well as the Guyana Stock Exchange.
At Gafours, we've been manufacturing PVC pipes and fittings for more than 35 years. Over this time, we've been able to perfect plastic manufacture and now have in our employ a plastic technician trained in the USA with a master's degree and more than 30 years experience. Our products are quality certified by the Bureau of Standards. So for all your PVC pipes and PVC fitting needs, Consult our plastic expert, Mr. Intias. He will advise you on the type of pipes for specific purposes, while his experience will guide you on the various types of fittings you will need for connections. He can also advise you on water tanks of superior quality, along with PVC gutters and fittings. For superior customer service, superior quality, and competitive prices, it's Gafuru's, the name you can trust.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick fix for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Introducing the new Softex toilet tissue, now available across Guyana. Softex is silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp. Softex is soft and gentle to every touch. Even babies can use it. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. The choice is clear. Choose Softex toilet tissue, super soft and super durable, guaranteed.
Here's what went down at the Georgian Magistrate Courts on February 15.
Two Unity Place, South Ramfelt residents were on Thursday remanded to prison on a series of armed robbery charges. Sean Archibald, a 38-year-old construction worker, and Timothy Waldron, a 29-year-old ex-police officer, appeared before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan and they denied the charges. It is alleged that the duo on November 4, 2017, at Irving Street, Queenstown, while being armed with a gun, robbed Ria Shaw of a Toyota Allian motor car valued $4 million and a cell phone worth $30,000. It is further alleged that the duo, while being armed with guns on November 28 at Pier Street, Kitty, robbed Nadine Williams of a quantity of items valued $143,000. Additionally, the men are accused of robbing Williams of her Toyota Allian motor car valued $2.9 million. The unrepresented men were remanded to prison until March 3. Meanwhile, Waldron was also charged separately with the three counts of armed robbery. Particulars of the first charge alleged that Waldron, while being armed with a gun, robbed Rendrick Lane of a quantity of electronics and cash valued $590,000 on June 16, 2017 at Station Street, Kitty. It is also alleged that on the same day, Waldron robbed Roxanne Ramchan of $550,000 worth in Apple Electronics at gunpoint. Lastly, the court heard that on November 28, 2017, at Pier Street, Kitty, Waldron, while being armed with a gun, robbed Gedrick Lane of a Toyota motor car valued $2.5 million. He denied all of the charges and was remanded to prison until March 3. Reporting for MTV News Update, Godfrey Brooms.
The Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 760. Let's turn our attention to the Damar Harbor Bridge schedule. What Do People Say is next. Stay with us.
Gafoods has been Guyana's largest manufacturer of steel products since 1970, and we were the first to introduce Alu's Ink and pre-painted corrugated sheets, which are produced in several widths and gauges and can be cut to any desired length. They're available in ripple, non-ripple, clay tile, non-clay tile, and trapezoidal designs. We supplement our corrugated sheets with curved sheets and ridging in Alu's Ink and pre-painted finishes. Also, galvanized deckings for casting concrete floors, manufactured in several thicknesses, and can be cut to any length from 6 feet to 30 feet. Some of the other products produced by us are galvanized purlin in widths of 4, 6, and 8 inches, and to lengths 6 feet to 40 feet. BRC fabric in sheets 6.35 millimeters, sizes 20 feet by 8 feet, suitable for heavy concrete flooring or areas of heavy traffic. At Gafoos, we produce the best quality at the most competitive prices and also offer the best services in the hardware business. All our steel products are available at any of our 7 locations countrywide. Gafoos, the name you can trust.
Introducing our new brand of all-weather fiberglass rocking chairs for complete relaxation. We supply quality, durable, and low-maintenance indoor and outdoor table and chairs for your patio, restaurants, cafeteria, reception area, and much more. So sit back and enjoy quality products from FiberTech with guaranteed factory warranty.
It's Sino Mall's new arrival for Valentine's. Pick up these awesome strapless bras at $1,500 and a host of other comfortable bras at great prices and fit. Panties and sexy lingerie at $1,200. That's sure to create a stir and entice him. And for the MASH season, grab masks. Saucy swimwear at $1,200 of various styles and colors, along with rings. Character towels at $1,200. Tops and tights at great prices. Working shirts and pants at $1,800 and $1,500. Sizzling tops and short pants. Stylish watches. Slick slippers, traveling bags, and colored pocket bags. All at Sino Mall, 16 Crow Street, Georgetown, opposite the 40 Bus Park. Call now on 231-8200 or 617-6088.
Our topic on this week's edition of What the People Say is, should the oil and gas contract be renegotiated? Here is what the people had to say.
Yeah, I feel it would be better for us if they renew it, because it would find jobs for the youths. So I think it would be better. You see, it's better when the government create jobs for the youths, because when they idle, they do a lot of things. And, you know, they make the life uncomfortable. So it would be good. And I thank God for that.
So how would this tie in with the contract?
Well, when the contract is renewed, if they consider to do that, well, they're talking about the iRefinery, etc., and so on. So probably that would create jobs for their youths.
Yeah, go through back the contract. That's what the opposition says, right? What the opposition says is true. And what the people in the that came into the media, that had a thing at Marriott, that is true. And what Siri Rafael said, all is true. 2% cannot work. Go through the contract and let us work together as a people with the opposition. Right? Go through the contract. That is my point as a Guyanese.
No, I don't think it should. I think it's a great step for Guyana.
Well, my opinion of it, it should be renegotiated in the favor of Guyana. Because we would all be screwed upside down. We would all be losing.
What aspect of the contract?
For me, every aspect should be renegotiated and reconsidered in favor of Guyana.
Well, the government got the choice. I can't say the government got to. But when the government, on behalf of the government, I can't really say.
It should be renegotiated by all means necessary. And the Guyanese people should be in the forefront of such negotiation. Because it's our future we're negotiating if they want to put funds in the money and some fund that they want to benefit our future, then the Guyanese people should be the person negotiating though. Somebody, if we got 10 regions we got, let every region come together and elect persons just according to do elections, they elect persons and get a body, form a body comprised of the Guyanese people so that they could represent the person as in something like, I would, my understanding as a proportional representation system.
Well, on behalf of the heads government, right, they might be able to get a better view because from my point of view, I might not see it the way they see it. So they might know what is best for us.
For MTV News Update, I'm Rajesh Lakhan.
That's all we have for you in our newscast tonight. But before we go, here's a recap of our major headlines. President Granger taking COI one step at a time. Jagdeo warns against appointing top judicial officers without due consultation and approval. Many Shug workers will not receive benefits from NIS. And in court, South Rheinfeld duo remanded for a spate of armed robberies. The newscast can be viewed online on MTV's Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel. The news will be rebroadcasted later tonight at 23 hours and at 6 hours on Friday, February 16. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Thanking you for watching. Have a good night.